Yes, in addition to phenylethanolamines, alpha-adrenal receptors binds to variety of structures. One of the class of agents which binds to alpha receptors is arylimidazolines. Arylimidazolines. Therefore, in this learning dialogue, we are going to see two arylimidazoline class as agonist, their pharmacology and therapeutic action. When we look at the structure of arylimidazoline, you will find that aryl ring and imidazoline ring is separated by one atom bridge. This one atom is linked to carbon number 2 of imidazoline. Is there any similarity between phenylethanolamine and arylimidazoline? Yes, there is one similarity. When you look at the structure of phenylethanolamine, you will find that they are having basic skeleton of beta phenylethylamine, amino group, alpha carbon, beta carbon bonded to phenyl ring. So it is beta phenylethylamine. Is this same residue or same type of structural feature present in arylimidazoline? Yes, it is present. One of the nitrogen you can consider to be an amino group of imidazoline linked to alpha carbon. If you consider X to be a carbon, then it will be a beta carbon and phenyl ring. So beta phenylethyl amino residue type of structure is also present in two arylimidazolines. In some of the two arylimidazolines, this X or bridge is of carbon, and that carbon is mostly present in the form of methylene group. While in some, CH2 or methylene group is replaced by NH, and that gives two amino imidazoline class of the compounds. Now, when we look at some structures of this class, which are alpha receptor agonist, you will find that there is no imidazoline ring present. Instead of imidazoline, it is gonadino group separated from phenyl ring by two atom bridge. These compounds are also called as open ring imidazolines. Now, since we have learned the effect of alpha 1 receptor agonist and alpha 2 receptor agonist, you can pause here, think and write what effect alpha 1 and alpha 2 agonist have on vascular smooth muscle. You can continue later. I hope you all have remembered from earlier learning dialogues that alpha 1 agonist contracts smooth muscle, cause vasoconstriction, and there is rise in blood pressure, while alpha 2 receptor agonist are mainly centrally located, cause feedback inhibition or inhibition of norepinephrine release in presynaptic sites, therefore relax smooth muscles, and they are mainly used as antihypertensive agents. So here we are going to see or learn structure activity relationship of two aryl alkyl imidazolines. Now these compounds are consisting of CH2 or methylene bridge between phenyl ring and imidazoline ring. When we look at the structures of some of the compounds in this class, we will find that ortho position of phenyl ring or ortho position to the linkage of methylene is comprising of lipophilic methyl groups. What is the effect of this lipophilic methyl group on the activity? Lipophilic substitution at ortho position of the phenyl ring is responsible for imparting alpha 1 as well as alpha 2 agonist activity. But when we look at the structures of xylometazoline and oxymetazoline, you will find that apart from ortho position substituted by methyl groups, they are having some other bulkier substitution, and that bulkier substitution is present at para position. In xylometazoline and oxymetazoline, this bulkier substitution is tertiary butyl group. So what is the effect of this bulkier substitution at this position? Bulky lipophilic group at para or even at meta position gives selective alpha 1 agonist activity. Therefore, xylometazoline and oxymetazoline are alpha 1 agonist. There is third compound, which is napazoline. You will not find any methyl group here, but you can consider ortho position and meta position to be substituted by alkyl groups, as this position in the ring is fused with one more ring, that is phenyl ring. So actually substitution is present at ortho as well as meta. Therefore, it is also alpha 1 agonist. Since these three compounds are alpha 1 agonist, they comes under the class of 2-aryl alkyl imidazolines. They are potent vasoconstrictor, therefore used as nasal and ophthalmic decongestants. Now, replacement of CH2 by NH gives us 2-aminoimidazoline class of drugs. These compounds are mainly have orthochloro group instead of methyl group. But most important difference is presence of NH bridge instead of CH2. Now, this may be the reason which imparts alpha 2 agonistic activity to clonidine. Now, since chlorine are present at ortho position, or clonidine is consisting of chlorine, therefore it travels to the central nervous system where it binds to alpha 2 receptors. Clonidine is hypotensive, therefore it is used as antihypertensive drug. Clonidine binds to the alpha 2A receptors in the central nervous system, which produce inhibition of norepinephrine release, while tizanidine binds to the alpha 2C receptor and produce analgesic and antispasmodic effect. Now, extensive research on alpha 2 agonist have shown that imidazoline ring was not necessary for alpha 2 agonist activity, but phenyl ring required at least one orthochlorine or methyl group. These efforts and these studies have led to development of gonabenzene and gonafacine, which are open ring imidazolines, where gonadino group is separated from phenyl ring by two atom bridge. These are also clinically useful antihypertensive agents. Their mechanism is similar to clonidine. They are the references. Thank you.